watching your every move. I've been drowning in the sweet love and empathy. Now bow down, now bow down, 'cause this is gonna hurt. She's my baby, man, they're taking her away. Now she's leaving me. Now she's leaving. She waits in the city lights again. She waits in the city. She waits in the city lights again. Now she's leaving me. Now she's leaving. Rose, I'm sorry to see you go. Hey now, Rose, I'm sorry to see you go. Wait now, Rose, I'm sorry to see you go. Wait now, Rose, I'm sorry to see.
Oh, thank you very much.
Adam Spark approached me about a year ago for this, because we'd worked on the previous album, and I'd done the string arrangement for Medicine. And then at some point we decided to maybe take the songs a little bit left of center to what they are in the album. I would go away and come up with ideas, apply them on the keyboard, give the guys an idea, come back, and we'd go, yeah, nay. And over the few months, we'd come up with an arrangement for each song that we felt gave the song enough of its own character without being, you know, just another string thing behind a pop rock song.
This is called Wide Eyed Boy.
Far between, assuming it's my first time, assuming it.
good to many. Sell your soul, you're no good to any. How much can you take? Thank you very much. We're going to do another, and then we're going to take a quick drink, a quick break, so you guys can get some drinks and we can get some more drinks, and then we'll come back and we'll do some more.
This is Birdland. This is our little space. This is our little home away from home, where we we write and we work and we come in every day. You know, we've sort of decked it out here with cool lights and posters and all this recording gear, and I guess for the last year this has kind of been our office, our working space.
Rehearsing for the Broken String, so come on in and check it out. This is a lovely little place called Loop. And as you can see, this is kind of where it's all coming together, with the string players and all the monitors and many microphones, and just kind of where I sit and do my thing here. So we've got all the guitars and bits and pieces and a heap of leads and buttons and lights, chairs, waters, laptops, the works. This is Kenny's like station, I guess, post. As you can see, it's there's nothing here. He's got a lamp and a stool. That's what he contributes, a lamp and a stool. This is where our beloved Jacko sits. He's probably the most heavily loved member of the band. And he's got his little custom stool that he got sent over and all this other crap which I don't even think he's using, but he's got a light as well, but his light doesn't work. I think that's maybe a kind of saying something there, his lights out. This is Westy's little corner of loud rock and roll. He's got this crazy new drum kit thing which looks like a big fucking tiger. I think it's worth about bloody $200 million or something like this, so
you know, he just sits there and bashes away. He's got his little hot rod sticks on this one, so he's feeling a bit, you know, he hasn't quite got his big manly rock on with his sticks and all that sort of stuff. So I think he's feeling a bit undermanned with his little rods, but we think it sounds quite pretty, so... So we've got our buddy Glenn on the tour. He's our sort of little right-hand fifth finger or thumb or whatever. And he's playing the grand piano on this one. And he's absolutely shredding it. So this is kind of where he's been sitting doing his little magic every day. He bought this thing, a melodica or something, melody horn. And I don't know how to work it, but it's like a keyboard with a blower thing on it. He thinks it's rad and it sounds pretty disgusting, but you know, it's kind of funny. This is where the string quartet's sitting, so you've got Rebecca and Karis and Ben and Matt, and these guys are absolutely pretty good. It's pretty humbling to play with, you know, guys like this, so you know, we're hopefully they're enjoying it, but it's sounding really, really cool. And they sit here every day and work away with Anthony, who scored the whole thing out, who sits here. He's got a little desk with peanuts on it and some kind of chocolates. These guys are just bringing in chocolates and peanuts and all sorts of stuff. So we're trying to be healthy and be, you know, sort of fit and clean living sort of rock and roll people. And here comes the classical crew with their chocolate and peanuts to rub it in our faces. And I can't eat peanuts because my throat closes up. So fuck you, Anthony.
My head in my hand. all the same.
This really is a lovely room. We've played some really, really special theatres and some beautiful places on this tour. It's completely different to what we normally are—a rock band. So this is a welcome change. It's very civil. It's the most civil thing I think we've done. So,
and we're getting quite used to it as well.
Yeah. This ain't gonna change. What difference does it make to save your sanity? I've seen you on the street, I still don't know. Oh my God, you're quiet. Very quiet. No, that's a good thing. It's a good thing.